folks, Dave, the man from the East, the actual true solver of Forrest Fenn's treasure hunt. I'm going to give you the Superman solve here. I know there's a lot that leads up to why Superman is involved in this. Some folks, you may have watched my other videos, you may not have. I'm just giving you some of the clues out of the book that pinpoint why Superman was important in these stories. It's all going to be laid out right in front of you. I'll put the pictures up as I talk. The first book, not realizing it, he brought in Hulk in one of his stories. All these little clues and hints that he brings in for the actual solve and how to connect it all together is kind of brilliant the way he does it. And he says it for the, you know, it's not going to be a direct route for the person who doesn't know how to get to the treasure, but the person who really knows, if you were to stay home and study all of this and figure out all of his demented little gatherings of his thoughts of how they connect and intertwine, you would know exactly where to go at the end of the whole story, and you would end up at Palisades Hill, pull in that parking lot and park right in front of that cross, and you would find Lewis and Clark Kent. Kent is right there. Folks, it is laid out for you, so simple. And I still have my people who harass me, which it's not going to matter. This goes out to the people who want to learn what Forrest Fenn's mind was really like. There are so many innuendos in these books of good housekeeping, of a hit parade that he would listen to with his parents, magazines, news stories, TV shows he brings up. This is all bringing it in. Even stout-hearted men. There's a story, stout-hearted men, from one of the old actors. There's so many that he brought in. The actual Lewis and Clark story about going out looking for Lewis and Clark, it's actually, you are supposed to be looking for Lois and Clark. And the Clark is the Kent that's on the cross. All these little connections that fit together. I'm just going to give you some of them. I don't have the time to keep going back through these books over and over and over again to find these little hints. I did on the first book, The Thrill of the Chase. I saw the Hulk innuendo that he brought in, which was, it's just that one little word, Hulk, but it is connected with, he's not going to lay it out for you and talk about Superman in the story. He's going to talk about other superheroes, and there's even a story that he said, I'm not a hero. But he talks about flying all the time and teaching other guys how to fly. Who else flew? Superman flew, right? So these connections that I'm going to show you and give you, the Lewis and Clark, they are all magical to figure out the end of this whole solve. He talks about the guy when he got fired, about getting canned. If you look up the terminology of canned, it's TV shows. And when you lost your job on a TV show, you were canned. That's what that innuendo is. That's why he brought that in. There's so many things. I also found Bessie, the story about Bessie, the cow. Take a look at this little quote from what a Bessie is. How they can punch like Superman or kick like Superman. I don't remember. I think it was punch. Actually, it's all so creatively genius what Forrest did. And the folks that want to diss it, you're just missing the boat. Because this will, I swear to God, when you look at every single thing together, you will see this is the actual solve of Forrest Fenn. There's nothing missing, folks. I find more and more and more of little innuendos and hints that pull it together even more. But as far as every single thing solved, I have that for you, folks, and I've given it to you. So let's move on to a couple other things here. This was kind of a big one. My War for Me. He has a little quote there, a little poem that he reads, that meant a lot to him. And I knew right at the beginning, courage wears a crimson coat. Crimson. You know what crimson is, right? The color red. Courage wears a crimson coat. Now, who else do we know wears a crimson cape? He's not going to tell you cape. He's going to tell you these things that he brings in is so close to give you that little nudge towards it, but he's not going to give it to you straight out of his mouth and in his stories. He's going to make you work for it a little bit. But that right there, it's crimson coat. Who else has a crimson coat? Do you know of anybody? No. Okay. The helicopter was called the Jolly Green Giant. Now, I know that that was my... When I came back and looked, I was thinking, oh, that's probably his innuendo on the Hulk. But then I found the actual word of the Hulk earlier in the book. So I didn't need to use the Jolly Green Giant as the Hulk. But that's another one right there that could possibly directly mean the Incredible Hulk. There's so many things that connect you to Palisades Hill. And My War for Me has so many innuendos of that cross that was so important to him. And I bring in the Esther, the ugly duckling, the why can't you and Esther were from TV shows that were so important. It's the Clark Kent Aunt Esther. And as far as Superman Solve is what I call it. It, why not, right? It's the most important thing once you realize what's on that cross. At the end of the map that leads you directly and precisely to Palisades Hill parking area. It is this solve, folks. If you haven't watched my other videos, you're just going to say, oh, this is another kook. But when you put it all together, and there's so much information here, that's why I have so many videos spread out. I probably have ADD. I'm sure I do. I have some type of dyslexia. I talk with my hands. Big deal. There's so many different things. When my mind starts working on this whole solve, it goes in so many different directions, but it can still pull it all together to see what the actual solve is. And there are people out there who see it. Even though my wacky way of explaining this is different angles and pointing to different directions that bring it all back together for that cross that sits at Palisades Hill. All the different Palisades innuendos with the windows and even describing in the third book a wall of trees, which is a palisade. There's so many things that bring it in and there's a few that know, but there's more that are catching on. And there are going to be a lot more when you really start looking at the solve for the way it is. And as I said, I didn't go through these books 100% again to find every single clue. I pulled out a few, but what I wanted to concentrate, I didn't even bring anything out of the second book. The third book is what I wanted to concentrate on to show you. I solved this and then I realized it was Superman. And the things that I found in the third book, him talking about the different superhero, the funny magazines, as he called them, those were huge for letting me know, validation, that he's trying to let you know there's a superhero involved in the story somehow. So that Superman solve that I talk about, it's exactly in the story about experiences with Joe, okay? He talks about Captain America, reading the funny books. There's another superhero, Submarina, and Captain America that he talks about were his favorites. Now, he's not going to have a story that brings you to Captain America because he's talked about that. He's bringing in these connections with superheroes to try to let you know there is something important about a superhero in his stories. And he had three pages of these, folks, not just one. Captain America, he had that page, the front cover. Plus, he brings in another one. There's three pages of this. Okay? Experiences with Joe. Captain America. There's Submarina. He brings in Hulk earlier in the first book. These connections are to let you know there's a superhero in his solve somewhere. And if you can't find it, you're never going to find it. But that's who it is. It's Superman for the Kent, which is looking for Lewis and Clark. You're literally looking for Lois and Clark Kent. That's where the Kent falls in, folks. That's why I call it the Superman solve. There's so many other things that are involved in this solve that it's more than just a Superman solve. But that is critical to let you know when you find the cross with Kent on it and the connection between Kent and Esther to be Canester. If you can't figure out the first clue, you might as well stay home and play Canasta. Canasta. It's the same thing as Michael Hunt out of Porky's. You people that don't get this, that's okay. There are a lot of people who do. And I feel bad that you don't see the magic, but that's okay. I'm laying it out right in front of you. And I'm going to try to keep this. I was going to put a lot of stuff in here with all the different innuendos of the different radio stations, A Sunday Kind of Love, all the different things that he brings up with TV shows. Oh, another huge one that I do have to touch on is another guy in the third book. He talks about Clark. He talks about, his name is Clark, and he says he's getting a lot of publicity. Clark Kent was a news reporter. So that publicity is newspaper articles that he's supposed to be writing instead of he's being a superhero during the shows. But he's a reporter and he's winning a lot of awards. So I don't know how many awards Clark Kent or Superman got for shows. I like him. I've always had Superman stuff. My checkbook has a Superman emblem on it from 14 years ago. It's always been something. My daughter gave me that Superman pin I wear sometime in my other videos, probably 8 years ago, before I even had any knowledge of Forrest Fenn's treasure hunt. Superman's been an idol of mine for forever. He's an idol of Seinfeld. Same thing. He has Superman on the refrigerator. But these connections in the book, when you really start looking for these connections for the solve, you will find them, folks. There are a ton more. It's 15 years. It's not going to be one or two hints out of the book. There are so many fine-tuned connections in here that bring you to the Superman solve. Let's call it that. That are just, it's fabulous. And I want people to understand it. Now, I've heard Chasing Indy say that there's a lot of stir up in the, like, people are stirred up in the Fenn community. And they're not sure why. They're not sure what's happening. I'm telling you, as soon as the Fenn community realizes that this is the true solve, that's when the shit is going to hit the fan for them up in Wyoming on their fake solve. And I feel bad if you folks believe that Wyoming was the final resting place of Forrest Fenn's treasure. It was not. It was New Mexico. It was Cimarron Canyon, New Mexico, at Palisades Hill. I will 100% guarantee that. And I believe that I proved that. And a lot of people see it because they've taken the time to watch my videos and understand how the clues connect. That's the biggest thing, is understanding how they interconnect with each other. All the different clues that I bring in and how they line up. The actual map. The actual 9 clues. It's all there, folks. I've given you every single thing. I've given you J.D. Salinger. I've given you the Canasta. I've given you T.S. Eliot. Why you end up back down where you started. The cease is that main word in the poem where it lines up where you're supposed to go back where you started. Perfectly. This is all absolutely 100% lined up actual factual clues that pigheadedness and laziness to watch my videos are the only thing stopping you, unless your mind just won't let go of your own solve. But it's the only thing stopping you from knowing what where Forrest Fenn's mind and creativity all connects. And I hope that you really look at it constructively. I don't care about getting criticized a little bit for something that you don't see. But when people are blatantly cruel about, oh, it was in Wyoming and that's that. So there's no possible way that it could have ended up a different situation where Forrest might have blurted out to somebody he trusted that he thought the treasure chest was taken. And that person went out and dug it up. And there's a reason why people talk about on these other channels, people talk about the chest is half empty now, because you know why? Because it's been given to all the people who are connected, different pieces of it and parts. And it's a shame. It's a shame. Those people, they are really pieces of shit. I'll tell you right now. They have destroyed everything, every single thing that Forrest has put his heart and soul into for somebody to find that treasure chest. Now, when I actually found the final resting place that you, a lot of you don't believe, but it was the final resting place, I let Forrest know that it had been found. I didn't tell him whether it was retrieved or not. And that was July 2019. And the shit hit the fan after that. And everybody knows that. They know. For timeline working out, something happened in August of 2019. A couple of months after. There was a secret email that went to Dal, that went to Pam Chatrone, I guess. I'm not sure where it went. There was knowledge that the poem had been solved, but no knowledge of whether or not the treasure was retrieved. Now, Forrest said that was going to stay between the solver and himself. Well, he didn't hold up his agreement. I told some friends of mine to grab the cross, and people are out so upset. Oh, you grab that cross. It's a graveyard. It's a grave marker. It's not, folks. It's just a marker for the searchers of Forrest Fenn's treasure hunt. That was all that marker was. That cross was so friggin' important. And do yourself a favor. Read back on My War to Me, and you will see how important and how he thought that cross, he was going to bring it back in somehow. And he did. He said, when I was in that plane, I melded the thoughts together of how I was going to connect it. So that cross, that is everything, folks. And the Kent and Esther are his favorite TV shows and movies and stuff when he was a kid. It all connects so beautifully. And the loopy people who think that Forrest is still alive, talking shit about him, saying he took the treasure chest. He didn't. And you folks know that. You folks know that when Forrest realized that the treasure had been literally found, like retrieved, this was all done behind his back. My guess, definitely Jack's ugly face up front, but my guess is Shiloh. But he hasn't come forward to say, no, it's not me. I will tell you what the real solve is. No, Shiloh is erasing Forrest's emails. Shiloh is backing Jack 100%. Yet they give you a place, but they won't give you anything for a solve. They let you try to figure out somewhere that's not even connected to the treasure, folks. You're trying to figure out where Warmwaters halt in a river that's 400 miles away from where you're supposed to be, or however many miles it is. But you are down the biggest rabbit hole, the jackrabbit hole of a lifetime in Wyoming. I hate to tell you, folks, the Superman solve, this is the actual factual solve of Forrest Fenn. I'm not angry with you people. I know this pig-headedness that just won't see it and won't accept that somebody else solved it. But the people out there that have the imagination, and I actually said that, you are the maker of dreams. You are like Willy Wonka said, so shines a good deed in a weary world. Toby, show me you care about Forrest Fenn. You are the one that could say, this solve makes sense. You're never going to get it from Jack. Dal Nisel, you're the one that gets the email from Forrest. I heard recently, maybe it's true, that you came forward and said that something about 1 9 mile doesn't work out. I applaud you for that if you really said that. There are people out there that know. Preston, you know shit that's gone on. Whether you've been paid off by Forrest's family, I don't know if there's a gag order on all of you. That it is a shame that you don't step forward and say something. Sasha, I've got a video that's going to come out that's going to show the email you sent me. Whatever, I'm gonna put lay it all out now. So I'm putting it out there. You knew within 4 days after Forrest Fenn received the picture from me, you knew that somebody got really, 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 really close to the treasure. Now, Forrest didn't give you all the information, but that tells me that he's telling people that it was solved, okay? He just let you know somebody was, like, at the final place, which was the cross, when I sent him the picture of that cross. So you knew 4 days after Forrest received that, sometime in August or whatever it was, when I finally sent him the picture and got everything together, because it was the end of July that I found the cross, okay? Because I emailed you in September of 2019, and I'll do a video on those emails again. I have them from way back, but I'm going to do it a little bit better this time, and I'm going to explain why. Now, people talked about bunnies, Forrest Fenn's favorites. Yeah, you were friends with him, Sasha. You should be standing up for him right now. You should be saying, yeah, you know what? He did tell me this, or he told me that. Big deal. I don't give a shit that he gave you information. He's not telling you where the chest was. He might be telling you from as a friend about some certain people getting closer. And you knew that. And you said that in your video. A half an hour into the video, you said, somebody is really, 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 really close to the treasure chest. Was it the same guy who said he was all done searching last year? You knew. You absolutely knew, Sasha, that I told Forrest I was all done because of the shitty trip I had with my buddy and my son. It was just not a good trip, not a good vacation. And I told Forrest that I gave up, but I didn't. I kept working on it. But you knew these things, folks. You don't know the whole story of every single thing that I have that I can give to the people who are asking questions. That's who I need to watch my videos. You people who want to know the actual solve and what happened when and why. I don't know the story behind who Forrest told the LLC for Wyoming, for all these connected videos, vlogger sites. I don't know all of that crap. There's a lot of smart people out there that are in that direction who can help. And as I said, we need a team to get together. Well, if you want to know where to start, you need to have the actual solve, folks. You're all guessing. I'm telling you right now, this is the actual solve. Everything is solved here. Everything is pulled together. Everything is already there. It's in order. I could say it 1,000 times, but you still get the Forrest Fenn community, which will not give up their own solve because of pigheadedness. There is a solve out there, folks. There is a stir in the community for Forrest Fenn's. Forrest Fenn's community. You and nobody will get together except for that Brady Bunch blocks of people that you do useless talking for 6 hours. I just saw another video. Someone put another one that I watch his videos sometimes. Over 4 hours. I am not going to spend 4 hours watching someone talk about what they had for dinner and who's going to Girl Scouts and whatever. You people, I try to get on and I try to give you all information and dates and things that work out and why they work out. So everything being connected, when you finally see the actual solve, you will see how brilliant Forrest Fenn is. And again, I say it's my solve, but it's really Forrest Fenn's solve. Forrest Fenn is the one that came up with this. So I give him credit. But all of you guys I mentioned, Dale Neitzel, Preston, Pam Chatrone, or whatever your name is. I don't even watch your videos. I'm sorry. I don't. I see you on other videos. Sasha, Bill Gorman. Bill, you just can't let go of the mammoth dinosaur poop up in wherever you are. I don't know. But you can't get it. You can't fathom it in your head that it wasn't in Wyoming. There is a person that they are afraid of up in Wyoming where the lies are. And Jack is afraid of one person. And they email me. And it is going. This solve is going places. And they know it. So they are preparing themselves for when the Fenn community finally gets the head out of their ass and realizes what the real solve is. I'm sure, Richard Rutherford, you're a hell of a good guy. You're probably going to say, Dave, you're too brash with them, whatever you want to call it. You're too hard on them. I'm not. I'm just telling you like it is. Someone needs to step up and say, the truth is out there. Listen to it. But these connections were just the Kent that was on the cross. That was so important to Forrest that he said he would bring it in to his story somehow. They don't have a cross up in the Broken Blaze, Wyoming, 9 rabbit hole, whatever the hell you want to call it up there. I don't know. Have they given you anything? Really? Okay, I'm going to try to wind this down. I got off the Superman subject. I started rattling like I do. I'm sorry. I just want you people to understand. That's all. It is so simple, yet so complicated for the solve itself. But it is simple. And when you see it, and it all connects, it's a beautiful thing. Don't let Forrest Fenn's 15 years go to waste. You people who are supposed to be friends with him from the beginning. And again, I say Toby. Sean Dobson, you were great. I used to watch your videos all the time. You were an open-minded person, but you've gotten out of it completely. I don't know what happened to all of these other old vloggers. You got fed up, you got frustrated, whatever. But now I'm coming to you, asking you, come out of the woodwork. Look at this solve. There are videos where, yes, I am an asshole. There are videos, yes, I'm funny. There are videos, I try to have everybody join together as friends. I've done it all to try to get everybody to be a Fenn community. Because you know what community is supposed to be, right? And it just doesn't seem to happen. No matter what I do, no matter what I say, people are just, they are stuck on their own solve and can't get their head out of their own ass. That's the bottom line of what it is. They're just stuck on their own solve. So realize if somebody came up to me, I try to look at things from every angle. When I look at how something happened, I try to look at it constructively from this person's point of view, from that person's point of view. So I can be open-minded and look at other people's solves. And I do. But I don't see a solve out there that has every single thing solved. And there are people who say they do. They are not. They do not. And it's, folks, just join me. That's all I'm asking. I just noticed I got a jump in my followers. Thank you. I appreciate that. And this video will probably put it over the edge. I'm hoping, because Superman is pretty cool. And Forrest Fenn bringing 3 pages of superheroes, but he doesn't bring in Superman. He brings in all the others. He brings in the Marvel characters. But DC, he leaves out Superman, but he brings in Hulk in the first book. And Clark, he brings in Clark a few times in this book about being... It's all so beautifully mastered and crafted together. I just hope that you see it. That's all. And I will let you go. I've rattled off enough. I'm not going to spend 4 hours starting to talk about what I'm going to have for dinner and then what I'm doing tomorrow and taking my mom wherever. It's not going to happen. I give you the information. Do what you will with it. Be open-minded. Think about it. Look at it constructively. And if you can't look at it constructively, get somebody who can and sit down with them and watch the video. Especially the videos that I just recently did, the one and only true video, has most of everything in there. I'm just giving you what's on the cross right now, Clark Kent, and how I came up with it. Okay? It's that simple. It's all connected. It all pulls together. Look at it. And give me your comments. If you have questions, I try to answer. It's hard to answer a question and have enthusiasm about it. I put a lot of exclamation points. I probably put 16,000 in all of my videos because I want people to, it's important and I want people to understand it. So I'm going to leave it at that. This video is going to take a little while to download and I've gone way past what I wanted to. A couple of things I wanted to bring in also are the terminology bread. He had the word bread 2 times in the first book. Again, I, as I said, I didn't go through the second book. I didn't go through the third book for any information of that word. But as far as the second book, you folks look through it. Tell me what you find that connects with superheroes or Superman or maybe Spidey sense somewhere. Who knows? I don't remember it. There may be something somewhere in the book. I have too many things to do and too much information I'm trying to get out. So that's why I'm putting this video the way that it's being put out. It's just a few things that are like main connecting points for Superman. All right. And bread is a huge one. It's a quote from Kal-El, Superman. They bred me. So I think that's huge. Folks, call it the Superman solve, whatever you want. Take it as you will. Keep an open mind. Have a great night. Thank you for watching. Please follow because it's going to get interesting. Once this level of where I'm at, along with the media company that I did the interview with, when that finally comes out, that's like a launching pad. And you people in the Fenn community that do not want to even acknowledge, it's going right by you. It is. This is a solve that will. When it gets in the right hands, you will know it is the right solve. I may not be the best at explaining it, but folks, it is the right solve. It is the right place. It is the right date to line up with everything you're looking for answers. So start asking questions. Contact me. My email is at the end of the one and only true video. Shoot me a message. Shy Guy's backed off from me. He still thinks that it's up in Wyoming and the treasure chest is still out there. The treasure chest is not. Shy Guy, you're a highly intelligent person. And you're the one that at least let me know I have a non-linear mind. So that tells you right there. It's not all one line thing. There's so many different things that bring it all together. So, folks, have a great night. I am Dave Woodard, the man from the East that actually solved Forrest Fenn's treasure hunt. And all of these clues, all of these hints, they all are magically put together for you to see that it is the actual factual true solved. Folks, have a great night. Thank you. Take care.